Good afternoon. We're so glad you're here.
Your daily vlog. So if you enjoyed today's video, you should come back.
We are on our way to our fertility clinic right now for my HSG, aka dye test, aka no fun at all.
Aka, we are super grateful and happy we at least can keep doing this.
Yes.
But it's still...
it's not comfortable. But we will bring you along as always. And then we will be on our way to preparing for another frozen embryo transfer.
We're home, thinking about asking Sarah if we can creepy Santa out year long for our emotional support, but that's, oh, she's got comfortable a little too far back. I'm in a different hoodie, as you can see. I'm staying home for the rest of the day for work. If you can tell on Sarah's face, my face, we're frustrated. Oh wait, let's preface. Overall, we're good.
We're good.
We're good for another transfer next cycle.
Mm-hmm. They found that my left tube was completely blocked. So it's just like my last HSG, they were a little uncertain about it. Didn't say anything about it in the DNC or my surgery. So
the thing about the HSG is it's ink and it's, we believe it's ultrasound. It's not, we don't think it's recorded.
Well, they put an x-ray over my stomach. And then I see, like, I watch them do it.
Because it's kind of like an MRI. But yeah. From the way, like, this is Sarah's technically her third HSG. And she's had a DNC, and she's had a laparoscopic endometrial surgery. So, like, our doctor is aware Sarah's got kind of wonky-shaped fallopian tubes. They've had concern about that left tube being blocked before, but they've never said like, oh no, that's 100% blocked.
Yeah, like no dye went through it. So basically they put in the catheter, they put the dye in my uterus, it goes through the tubes and back into the uterus, and like it just didn't go into that tube at all. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't affect IVF
because my uterus looked
good. Yeah. Right.
And the whole concept of IVF is you go from the egg to the lab, like the ovary, take it out of the ovary directly in the lab, from the lab into the uterus. It right. bypasses the tubes, so
yeah,
it doesn't affect IVF. But it's just like the uncertainty of it all, like why is it blocked? Do we need to be concerned if it's blocked?
Like, and
if
you investigate it more, put off the frozen embryo?
Will it kick us out of the medical study?
Right.
These are all the questions that we sent to our study staff, mm-hmm. like our wonderful nurses and our doctor, because it's just frustrating because like, okay, I know we can't look too far in the future, but it's like, well, what issues will this cause in the future, say for any potential naturally conceived children? Is it going to be an issue during pregnancy? Like,
yeah.
All those
what
things.
What the heck?
We can't seem to leave those offices without
a question or like.
It's never 100% awesome. There's only been two times where it's been 100%, or one time it's been 100% awesome. Because even when like we were left with embryos and everything, it's just like it's a bummer that we have to do that.
Yeah.
And we're going to do what we have to do, but it's just, we need a trip, not leaving like we should go spend $100 at Market on South.
So that is, they said in the office, this should not affect IVF. But like this is like a procedure that's done so commonly that like they don't know our story, they don't know our background, they don't, like, it's all in our paperwork, of course, but it's just like, it's not like our team was there to tell us. So I'm just
wait for them.
Hopeful that we'll hear back from our nurses soon.
Yeah. And everybody's different just as much as like, it's not just about an IVF and the baby and all these things. Like, there's lots to it. There's emotional stress, there's the physical stress, there's the tolls, the uncertainty, the financial aspect, because we have been really blessed with our medical study, but like, what happens if that changes, and timing and everything.
It's a lot. It's heavy.
But we are happy.
Mm-hmm.
But we wish we could push all this uncertainty away. now we do have to finish the rest of our work day.
I'm hungry.
I know, so am I. A few hours later, I finished work. So I went to the acupuncturist, did some cleaning up, did some dishes. I'm soaking in last minute princess switch. I think we're gonna head out to get ready for the preview night of whatever it's called, Magic Kingdom Fireworks, Fantasy in the Sky. They're still singing Christmas songs. We parked at Ticket and Trench today. We didn't even try to park at the Poly because it's New Year's Eve. It's the busiest week of the entire year. They're gonna be like, I'm sorry, we needed your social security card to stay here, to park here. So we didn't even try, but we parked all the way. We parked all the way in the back.
Cruella.
4:33.
I've even parked in Cruella.
You have, that is a dramatic statement. But we parked, we were six or seven rows from the very back of the Magic Kingdom parking lot.
I feel like right now when I wear a bun like this that I look the most like my sister.
Your sister Jenna.
My sister Jenna.
Yeah.
And we are meeting up with her and Billy at the Poly. So I'm wondering if like after a long day at the park if her hair's gonna look like this, then you guys are really gonna think.
I have always wanted this. For my birthday? Do you see it? It's so cozy, and this is my favorite logo.
That's the inside of that zone I want to get a tattoo of.
Are you looking at some plants?
Yeah, I'm getting my green thumb on.
This is Squidward's house. When it gets even remotely chilly at Disney, because they bring out these racks, and they're like, we have coats! You can buy your coats here! That one's really cute. So are these. This is awesome.
This is not awesome in the realm of Peter Brookhart. I'm just not a fan. You guys know I don't like dated stuff.
This looks like brass knuckles.
That, or it looks like Seussical. Like, that's not Disney. And the photos reminds me of like a 90s mug. We just realized we have almost 3 hours.
Which is fine. Like, there's plenty to do in Sweden.
There's plenty of relaxing areas to hang out in. But I kind of want to adventure and walk over to Grand Floridian.
See the gingerbread house one last time.
Maybe hear the piano player. Maybe we can check on your phone. I just picture Magic Kingdom being like absolutely bonkers right now. So I think I vote Grand Floridian. What do you vote?
Grand Floridian.
You can't see anything, so there's going to go shine a light on it. But look at this monstrosity. Granted,
remember yesterday when we joined Club 33?
Yeah, I wish. Granted, like, they pay a lot of money, so it's a great perk. But this entire secondary little beach right by, what is the thing over there called? Spirit of Aloha. In between the main beach at Polynesian and Grand Floridian, Spirit of Aloha, this beach is all closed off probably for tomorrow night for Club 33 members.
Wow. What's kind of cool is, like, that is cool. There's probably, like, drinks and food and stuff. But, like, we're going to do that tonight.
Yeah, but we're not Club 33.
No.
Not yet. Yeah. One day.
One day.
Plus, we can't even see in this shot right here. It's so dark.
We just missed the band, and no more piano player for tonight. But the smell is enough to bring us joy.
And the cheese here, and the gingerbread house is here. Maybe since it's New Year's Eve, I can go up and just rip a shingle off, and nobody will realize.
I realize we have marshmallows at home. We got to go do like a fire, like one of the fires at the resort one of these nights. Look at this cool schedule for tomorrow. New Year's Eve family dance party. Roasting marshmallows. Toy Story 4? Wow. Enjoy the top family movie of 2019. Wait. We were wrong. They're playing Grim Grinning Ghosts. And we got a couch right here. Good night.
trombone just had a solo that sounded so spooky, and I missed the whole thing. Like a scat cat.
I think we're going to go to Magic Kingdom on New Year's Day.
Park open?
Yeah.
Let's just not go to bed tomorrow night. Okay. Oh my gosh, we should try that.
Guys have got a big old crowd. Do you think that was, that sounded like a grand finale to me.
All right, we just got the call from Jenna and Bill. They're gonna head towards the buses, they're at studios. They're gonna meet us at the Polynesian, so we're gonna go check out the gift shop. We're gonna head back to the Poly. We got an hour and a half.
Gasparilla has an impossible burger now. Just thinking about it, thinking how close it is, thinking how it's difficult.
Let's go get two. We found something that I feel like I need to have. Look at this Tommy. It's only, I mean, like, it's a lot. It's 115, but for Tommy Bahama, I feel like that's
it's
a deal.
It's so nice.
It's nice, warm, but thin.
Guys, we're going on a cruise.
This is perfect for the deck, because we have a, not
we're
Savannah.
Going to the Bahamas.
What is it called? A veranda.
We have a veranda.
This could be nice at the nighttime with a glass of wine.
Guys,
on the veranda.
Going on a cruise?
In
2 weeks.
In like 15 or 16 days.
Yeah, 2 weeks from today. Right? Because it's a Monday.
Yeah,
we leave on a Monday.
We disembarked 2 weeks
from
today.
You only have one Monday left at work.
All right, we're back at the Polynesian. We got Christmas vibes going on. We did not get two Impossible Burgers, even though we really wanted them from Gasparilla. Now we wait for Jenna and Bill to show up, because they were, when we were in the lobby of Grand Floridian, they were walking out of the park to go towards the buses. So I don't know how the buses were
right. Looking.
Magic
Kingdom's open until 2 a.m., so like, you don't even know.
Extra
if
magic.
Gonna,
yeah. But they're staying on property, so they can go.
Yeah, so you never know. But there wasn't a big crowd out there. I was a little bit worried, but we're good.
Billy and Jenna made a droid. Is it stuck?
It's stuck on the tile, I think.
Okay, it's like, yeah. It's called R1123. That's their wedding anniversary. So cool. Look at this cool room and their fancy lights.
Snap 2019 vlog.
Yeah, maybe they'll have a, oh, I was gonna see if you can see if it actually goes to a 20, like they'll flip the switch right at midnight.
Nope, they not Disney.
No, they check out tomorrow.
We are home and we are almost done with our first year of this calendar, but luckily enough, it is a 2 year calendar. So we have a whole nother year of quotes, but today's quotes from the 30th from Mr. or Miss Anonymous, it's a good day to have a good day. Well, that's one of my favorites of the year. We also have something we haven't talked about yet, but I think we might have mentioned it. I don't know if we'll incorporate it every night into the vlog, but we're doing something. We're gonna like write down a sentence about every day of the year.
Oh yeah,
starting
we got a little
year.
Book.
So that'll be kind of fun to like pair that with the daily quotes. But
yeah, we also have a couple of changes. Additions, enhancements, coming to the vlog, January
1st. Oh, it was a hard date.
We said like the new year, right? One day Eve will come to Disney World with us.
It's good to be home.
Good to be home.
We know what our goals are. We know what we hope to accomplish. And believe me, it's the most exciting and challenging assignment we've ever tackled at Walt Disney Productions.